game here at the Sanford Health Athletic Complex at the Shield Center. 29-20, North Dakota State leads after a spurt in the last couple of minutes of that first half. Brian, Shawn, Freddy Coleman back with you. And, you know, give credit to Omaha. They pounded the paint inside with Pilakuta, made it three of her first four shots, and then missed four shots to end that first half, but they have not been able to really get consistent scoring, and then Mariah Murdy picking up three early fouls hurt as well.
That hurts them. But once again, they're playing well. They're battling. They're getting touches to Pilakuta, who's playing really, really well, but NDSU starting to take away some of the things that she's doing really well. So that's why you kind of saw NDSU gap as we kind of went, but NDSU's got to do a better job of taking care of that basketball. That's the big thing. And the better that they can shoot it, the better they can continue to keep getting in the gap, the more successful they're going to be as the second half rolls on.
Let's take a look at some of those first half highlights brought to you by Avera Orthopedics. And Pilakuta, as we talked about, they fed her a ton. They did this against Illinois State in their last game, too. They want to get her touches, Freddie.
Absolutely, but deep touches. And, I mean, that's 3 feet away from the basket there. And she's always going to demand that basketball. They're going to feed her. She's going to take her time. She's trying to get to that left hand. But if they can take that away, once again, they'll be able to succeed.
L.O. Gier, leading scorer for this Omaha squad, 6 points, 3 of 5 shooting in that first half. She also picked up a couple of fouls, but she can do it in a variety of ways, Freddie. That's what makes her dangerous.
She can, but I think O'Gier is one of those players that's a scouting report player, right? She's doing a lot of right-hand drive, getting to the rim. We've got to take that away.
Kylie Strop coming off the bench most of this season, got the start tonight. And a couple of buckets.
And I think Strop's the one that's really kind of making NDSU go a little bit. She's making some good floaters, some good touches. But she's getting her other teammates involved as well.
And Renia Hopkins, 7 points.
She's a spark plug, man. She's getting blocks on the defensive end. She's running hard in transition. Cobbins finds her here for a nice, easy layup. She makes a corner three. She's playing really well right now.
And the Bison started kind of slow, just 2 of 8 from three-point range, and then made 2 of their last 3 to end that first half. You talked about the turnovers. And maybe points off turnovers. Those catastrophic turnovers are the ones that can really hurt you.
Those are the ones that you want to stay away from. Catastrophic meaning a tip or deflection, going the other way for a layup. And NDSU's had a few of those, but once again, points off turnovers are huge. You can't give the other team money, right? They got to be able to earn it. So the more they can keep them in a half-court situation, and once again, play to their strengths, play to those scouting report things that coaches have been drilling into their head all week. They're going to have a good chance to win this game, but at the end of the day, they got to take care of that basketball, and they got to keep them out of transition.
All 20 of Omaha's points have come in the paint. Not any perimeter shots so far have fallen for the Mavs.
Oh, coming into this game, once again, from three, they're shooting 24% on the year. That's not great. So, once again, I think Omaha's doing a great job to play into their strengths. They're getting to the rim. They're feeding the post, the basketball. So they're trying to stay away from that three-point line a little bit, but once again, if they're going to give them, they're going to take them. NDSU is a really good three-point shooting team. Shooting 11, only 4 of 11 as of right now. But once again, if they continue to keep getting good shots, that percentage is going to climb.
All right, we will step aside and be back with some other scores from around the Summit League and get you set for the start of the second half here in Fargo. Bison leaded by 9.